Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and we're going to talk about what's out there this weekend at the movies. Well, number one, this is Rolling Stone, so I'm going to say Notorious is the movie to see. This is the story of Biggie Smalls, the rapper who was murdered in 1997. And the thing about him, when we talk about him, is that it's always about this murder. It's always about who did it because we don't know, because the LAPD screwed up so badly in this investigation that we'll never find out. No, this movie is about the life of Biggie Smalls. So forget finding out who done it. You're not going to find it out from this movie. What makes this movie work is a guy named Jamal Ward. He is a rapper in Brooklyn called Gravy, not a really successful one, never acted before until he took this part. And I'm amazed at what this guy does in this movie. He inhabits Biggie. He's big, you know. He gained some more weight to do it, but he has the look of Biggie. And he's got the voice. He's got the way Biggie tilted his head. He can do that, like in Juicy. He knows what he's doing. So why do I sound like I'm holding back a little here? Well, because the movie itself is an authorized biography. Biggie's mother, who's played by Angela Bassett in the movie, is one of the executive producers. And guess who else is one of the producers? Sean Puffy Combs is one of the producers. So the actor playing him makes him look somewhat like a saint. After a while, you get the feeling that the people who did produce the movie were going to make sure that they looked pretty good and put a kind of sanitized look on it. So what we're dealing here is the authorized biography. But what isn't sanitized, what is the explicit version, is Biggie's music. And it's all here in this movie. And to watch him doing party and bullshit, is just one of the fun things to look at in movies right now. So you get a great performance at the beginning of the year. Just don't expect too much honesty from the movie. Come on. Ha, sicker than your average. Pop a twist, cabbage off instinct. It's don't think jits. Gators, my Detroit players. Tim's for my hooligans in Brooklyn. That's dead right. If the head right, be there. Air life. So what else is out there? Defiance. Defiance, which is known in the business as the Tough Jews movie. It's World War II, and, you know, Joseph Stalin always said Jews were not good soldiers. You know, that didn't happen. Well, here's the movie, the true story that proves him wrong. Daniel Craig, James Bond, is playing Tuvia Belsky. His two brothers are played by Liev Schreiber and Jamie Bell from Billy Elliot. And these are Polish Jews who actually said, no, we're not going to sit and take this. We're not going to any camps. We're going to fight during this war. It's a great story. The sad thing is that the director, Ed Zwick, makes this movie a little bombastic. There are Hollywood scenes in it. I think Zwick is too good a director. He did Blood Diamond and Gory. To have thought of this himself. I think that Hollywood said, you know, we have to have a love scene for Daniel Craig. He's James Bond, so we get to see him in a tent with golden lighting. I mean, what is this? It takes away from the story a little, but the story is still sensational.
It is impossible.
Nothing is impossible. What we all have done is impossible.
All right. Scumbucket, you're all waiting for it. What am I throwing in there? Yes, people, it's another dog movie. I'm sure this is going to be number one unless Clint Eastwood in Gran Torino gets back and just blows these dogs away. But this is called Hotel for Dogs. It's as sappy as the title sounds. It's about orphans who have orphan dogs, and then they want to put all the orphan dogs in a hotel. Look, I've got to say to you right now, I love dogs. I have a dog. I think the dogs in the movie are great. The people I hate and the people who are in the scum bucket are the people who exploit them. You know, they can't think of a decent story. They can't think so. Cute dog on the screen. No, you people are going in the bucket and go there now.
And there's a lot more to taking care of them than feeding them.
I'm Peter Trapp.